you see the slide I presented? Can you see the slide?
Yes, madam.
Okay, thank you. It's a bit windy outside actually. The wind quite strong today. Yeah, I think I have almost 70 old students already. Okay, just for your information, the course today is Asas Pembudayaan Keusahawanan Entrepreneurial Acculturation course UW003-3302. So this is our first lecture. I will record the lecture for those who cannot attend the class today to watch the lecture. I will post it using YouTube later. Okay, so if you cannot see, maybe later I will post it again using YouTube. You can have a look. Today we are going to look at the outline of the course only. Okay. All right, I believe you can see me now. I just stopped posting, presenting. Okay, just a little bit explanation. For this course, this is UW003-02, Asas Pembudayaan Keusahawanan. All right, I believe you know that this course is for certain faculty only. It's not for this section. This section is certain faculty only. So normally, I will use the slide in English. Is it okay for all of you? Can I see your response here from the chat room? Is it okay for me to use English? If you have problem with English, then you let me know. You put in the chat, then I will explain a little bit more in Malay. Boleh kan? I think for your group of students, your faculty for English shouldn't be a big problem. Still a few more students are trying to log in at the moment, so we still have to wait for a few minutes for them to log in. But for next week onwards, I hope that you can try to log in slightly earlier. Okay, slightly maybe 5 to 10 minutes earlier, so that you will not have problem looking in. Okay, so this is our first lecture. Don't be so serious. I just explained the outline. Okay, saya terangkan apa yang perlu dibuat untuk kursus ini, untuk tari apa assignment yang perlu dibuat untuk individu dan kumpulan. Dan saya akan membuat kamu ikut kumpulan. Dan saya akan menerangkan juga dalam hari ini, lecture hari ini tentang bagaimana menggunakan Google Classroom. Saya percaya ramai di antara kamu sudah pernah try ataupun kamu sudah try. Sebab semasa saya post Google Classroom sebelum ini, saya nampak ada student sudah cuba jawab soalan survei ya, yang saya post dalam Google Classroom. Memang ini sangat bagus, okay, sangat bagus. Then you can try. Saya menggunakan Google Classroom ini sebagai satu platform. I'm using Google Classroom as a platform so that whenever you want to submit your assignment, either individual or group assignment, you can find it, okay, the link from the Google Classroom. And then I upload a little bit of contents already in Google Classroom. If you have a look before this, okay, I will post some course outline, course details a little bit in there. But at the same time, also you can get these details from Smart3 UMS. Okay, jadi you boleh pakailah mana-mana sama ada Google Classroom. Saya akan upload nanti dan juga di Smart UMS. Smart3 UMS. Jadi kamu ada pilihan sama ada kamu guna Google Classroom saja atau Smart3. Tapi kamu sangat digalakkan untuk menggunakan Smart3 UMS. Tapi saya kurang pasti sama ada Smart3 ini lebih senang digunakan atau tidak. Saya tak pasti. Cuma saya rasa kamu boleh try lah, mana-mana satu platform yang lebih memudahkan kamu, kamu bagi tahu, nanti we are more focusing on using that. Tetapi, policy UMS, UMS policy, is to use Smart 3 UMS, okay? Smart version 3 UMS. So, if you have problems in attending this class online, then I will post the recorded video in YouTube for you to watch later. So you still can watch it, but I require you, if you didn't attend the online class, like today, okay? If you didn't attend the online class today, but you watch the YouTube, then I require you to like the video clip. I require you to like the video clip after you watch the YouTube, but I prefer you to attend the class online like today. So then you have any question you can ask in the chat room, then I will answer you immediately. Okay, and I will also take attendance using the software Google Meet. Akan ambil attendance kamu, but at the same time I require you to fill in your own attendance using the Google form. Later I will show you the attendance list. Okay, I think most people already log in already. Let's go to the slide. I will explain a little bit about the slide, the course first before I show you the Google Classroom. Okay, then yes, I think somebody say something. Let me see. Kenapa tiba-tiba dia tak tengah? Orang lain tengah tak? Tengah? Okay. Kalau yang tak tengah tu mungkin ada line internet sikit lah, ada problem. Sebab tempat saya ni, KK ni sangat berangin. Tak tahu lah, mau hujan ke apa. Okay, so if you cannot hear, you just put in the chat room, then I will have a look. I want to see what happened. So now I share the screen first, for the course outline. Okay, I'll share this to you. All right, you can see this course online, can you? Boleh nampak course online? Okay, if you need to re-log, you let me know. I will go to another page for presenting page. Okay, course online for semester 1, session 2020-2021. This year is a very challenging year to you and to us, okay? Jadi, kitalah coba berusaha bersama untuk menjayakan kursus ini ya. Then I hope that we already try to make this course easier for you to do. Okay, of course not as easy as ABC, but we make it easier for you to understand what do you need to learn for this course. This course is the course Fundamentals of Entrepreneurial Acculturation course, which will explain to you how to do entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is the what we call very important skills that you need to learn. That is creativity and innovation. You need to learn these skills. Okay, without these two skills, next time it might be a bit hard for you to find a good job. I will not say you cannot find a good job, but most of the job today, they require you for a better creativity mind, innovation thinking out of the box. And at the same time, from this course, we hope that you can work together with people who you might not know. That is why we put you into groups without your consent, okay? Sorry to say that. Kami akan tentukan kumpulan. Tapi untuk semasa saya membuat kumpulan ini, saya akan cuba membuatkan supaya orang yang tinggal di KK akan dapat buat kumpulan dengan orang yang tinggal di KK. That is what I'm trying to do. Oleh itu, saya minta nanti kamu isi ya. Tolong isi. Please fill in a survey form. Later on, I will check the survey form to find out who are those in the same, maybe same city or same town or same area to work together. Kalau saya dapat lah. If I cannot, then I will simply put you into a group nearer to you maybe. Okay, this is what I can do for you. Okay, and we have to expect that the COVID condition getting even worse maybe the coming week. Okay, keadaan ini memang mungkin akan menjadi lebih teruk lagi lah, khasnya di negeri Sabah ni. serasa ramai di negeri Sabandingan. Jadi kita perlulah bersedia, mungkin sampai tahun depan pun kita guna online classroom. Okay, online to buat semua nih. Jadi we cannot escape. We have to do everything using online classroom. We have to do our activities also juga guna online classroom. Okay, so that is why we as an entrepreneur, we have to think of kalau keadaan ini tidak membolehkan saya buat secara kumpulan face to face, apa yang saya boleh buat dengan online business. Okay, so this is what you have to, you also can learn from the Google Classroom here. Okay, the course M, tujuan maklumat, tujuan khusus ini, the course M is to design for undergraduate students of all faculty except for FPAC to learn about entrepreneurship skill and to provide or to produce balanced and holistic graduates who have the entrepreneurial skills and capabilities. All right, so the course outline is first explain the basic concepts of entrepreneurial knowledge. Demonstrate creativity and innovative business with team members and perform digital business with team members. So next, the most important part is you have to know your assessment. In simple, we put our assessment into four different groups. Okay, sorry. Okay. All right, we have four different group of assignments here. The first one is individual assessment quiz. You can see quiz is 10%. For this semester, we only make it one quiz, but the marks for each quiz increased to 10. That means one quiz, 10%. The previous semester, they have two quiz and marks 5% for each quiz. But for this semester, again, this semester, you only have one quiz and 10%. And the quiz is for chapter unit 1 to unit 5 only. All right. So I will let you know how are you going to do the quiz. Likely, we are going to use a Google form also, Google Classroom to conduct the quiz so that you don't have too many platforms to do at the same time. This is the first thing, the quiz. The second assignment is individual assignment also. This is known as content creation, which is in total also 10%. So content creation, you can read it in more detail. Content creation is for creating two things. First is video creation, that is 5%, and photograph, another 5%. So for video creation, you are going to produce a video in about 1 to 2 minutes or less than 3 minutes. Okay, not more than 3 minutes, please. Less than 3 minutes, around 2 minutes, to either to review a product. So the purpose to review product is you as a businessman or you as a broker, you want to review a product so that people are going to buy your product. Okay, so put it in your mind. Review a product so that people will buy your product. Or review a product so that you encourage people to buy a product. That's the purpose for product review. Or you review a product so that you can introduce the product to new customers. That is another purpose. Okay, so as an entrepreneur's point of view, you need to review the product not because you like it only, but you want people to know the product and they might want to buy it, or you want to introduce a new product, or you want to promote the product so that people already know it and want to buy it. Okay, that's the first purpose. Or the second type of video is you do an advertisement. Right, an advertisement, so that for your advertisement, you can you can explain the product and do it like a normal advertisement that you always do. Okay, so that is advertisement. And then next, you also have to do take the same product for advertisement to take a photo, and then this photo you have to take it from top, Okay, imagine you put the product on the table and you take the photo from the top. Okay, take the photo using your handphone, whatever method, right? Take the photo, and then you can improve the photo using whatever apps you know. You are better than me most of the time. Huh? You know how to improve it, make it beautiful, and then make the photo like something that you can prepare for advertisement. You can add some statement, anything, then make it nice and beautiful. So another 5% for the photos. So altogether, you get 10% for content creation. This is individual assignment, right? So next, we go to group assessment. For group assessment, we have one group assignment that is what we call business model canvas. Business model canvas is a pre-business assessment. It means that you prepare this before business. You prepare a draft report and you present it. I will tell you when is the presentation timetable. And then during the presentation timetable, you have a maximum 10 minutes to prepare. Normally, I give you about 2 minutes to set up, a few minutes to set up, and then 10 minutes to present, and few more minutes to Q&A, right? So during this draft report, I will look at what have you prepared, and I will give you comments. And these comments, you really have to take note, copy down, and then improve your report. After that, you prepare a written report. So these two actually is one report, but you just present it first with your draft, and then you get the advice, you will get the comments from me, or you copy good method from your friends, whatever. Then you improve your report and you get a final report. You prepare a final report after that. All right, so I'll show you the date later. And then last will be the group assessment after business. We call it business e-portfolio report. A post-business assessment is 50%. This is the most important. And the business e-portfolio report, a post-business assessment report, then you the same thing, you have to prepare a draft after you present it. And then after you present it, and then you have to write a report. Okay, you have to write the report. So when we do the business e-portfolio, it is very important. You have to base on every member's experience when you do the business portfolio. Okay, you are not looking at just one, but everybody's opinions to make the report. So make it more suitable for the presentation so that you can present it later. Okay, so this is for individual assignment and group assessment. For individual assessment, the first one is the quiz during week 6. That is the 18th around November, okay, 16th to 22nd November, right? Then the individual assessment to be complete by 4th of December, both individual assessment by 4th of December. And then the first group assessment for the presentation of presentation of the draft is by 6th of November, and the final report is by 27th of November. Okay, and for the presentation of business e-portfolio is by 15th of January. This one I will arrange again. I will arrange the presentation timetable for you, and then the written business e-portfolio final report will be by 22nd of January. By that time, I hope that the year 2020 gone, and then we have a new life next year. So hopefully this will be the next year story. All right, so I will show you later in the assessment date in another Word document. For this content outline, you can download it using Google Classroom. Okay, you can download this content outline using Google Classroom. Before this, if you cannot download, maybe I forgot, I do the wrong setting. So I change it, delete the previous one, and then I upload this course outline again. I already upload it again, and then now it's easier for you to download. Okay, for the assessment. So the most important thing for ABK, I believe you know that we have to do, you have to do a business practicum from week 5 to week 10. Your question is maybe. Any question? 5 weeks, 6 weeks. From week 5 to week 10, it means that 6 weeks. Do you have to do selling for all 6 weeks? No. Okay? You don't need to do selling for all the 6 weeks, but you have to prepare your business from week 5. Meaning that from week 5, maybe you start to introduce a little bit for your business. For example, you start to promote a little bit. You say, we are selling a product. And then you ask people to guess, what do you think? What am I selling? Or if you already have the photos, then the week 6, you can start to promoting, or you show the photos, this is the product that we are going to sell. Are you interesting to buy? Interested to buy? Then you can start to a little bit promoting, and then you decide a date. Okay, maybe in between week 5 to week 10, you have 1 week of break. During your break, you can go out to sell. Maybe that is your decision. You want to go out to sell during that week, also can. Or you can do any other ways of selling during that week. Okay, so there are 5 different methods of doing business. You can choose whatever method, either one, not all, either one. So to do the business. Okay, before I continue, any questions? Please put your question in the chat box. Any question? If you have, just type your question now. Okay, 2 minutes. If you don't have questions, then I'll continue. I give you another time to, or any time you have questions, you type in the chat box, then I will check whether the question answer or not. If the question not answer, then I will answer it. Okay, for your information, for the latecomers, this video is recorded. Okay, recorded. So what type of product? Yes, I'm explaining now what type of business you have to do. Okay, Sharin, I'm explaining now to you. Okay, saya menerangkan segala apa bisnis yang Anda boleh buat. Okay, kalau ada soalan nanti, saya boleh jawab nanti ya. Saya explain dulu. I explain first what product you want to do now. Then, what product you can do it to now. Then, it will be slightly easier maybe for you to understand what you can do now. Yeah, okay, make it slightly bigger. Okay, the first product that you can do is to take order and deliver. Take order and deliver. For example, any kind of products, for example, food and beverage, beauty, household or crafting business, anything you prepare and then you can sell it. For example, what your seniors are doing is, they produce a product and then they do promotion online. After that, they, of course, they look for people staying because they are in certain place. For example, a group in Ipoh. So they look for people staying in that area. They look for business and then they sell to that area. So because of MCO, what we are experiencing now, what we can do is, of course, now you cannot go out, but later if you can go out, then this is one way. You prepare the food at home. Okay, how you prepare it, I don't know, but maybe with the help of your mothers or whoever, you prepare it, or you get some order for local producer. Okay, people who sell cakes or whatever. So you get the food and then you start to sell to local business. This is one way. Okay, within the same business, each group member may produce and or distribute different types of products to customer within their location. That's what I'm saying. Okay, orang yang tinggal di KK, kalau boleh kamu buat kumpulan dengan orang yang tinggal di KK, kemudian kamu jual lah produk dengan orang di KK. Tapi kalau ada satu kumpulan, ada orang papar, orang KK tempat yang sama, then apa boleh buat? Mungkin orang papa ni mereka jual satu produk di papa. You sell one product in papa and another group in KK, orang di KK pun jual barangan di KK. Tapi dalam industri yang sama. Mungkin orang di KK jual whatever thing that nasi nasi biryani khas ayam. And then another friend in Papua, mereka tidak pandai. Mereka nak buat nasi lemak khas di Papua. Okay, that is fine. Okay, sebab dalam industri yang sama. Okay, untuk satu kumpulan, kalau kamu pilihlah industri seperti makanan, jadi anda boleh buat makanan yang berbeza di tempat berbeza. Okay, yang penting ialah kamu semasa buat kerja yang last tu, semasa buat business e-portfolio report tu, anda mesti buat report itu bersama. Okay, and before that, BMC report pun mesti buat bersama. Promosi pun kamu boleh tolong buat bersama. Okay, so that is what we are thinking. Each group member is responsible for posting teaser, soft sell, hard sell posts. I will explain all this, teaser, soft sell, hard sell posts. That means what kind of promotion you can do using the social platform account, for example, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram, and TikTok. Maksudnya, setiap kumpulan mesti menyediakan satu Facebook account khas untuk syarikat yang kumpulan ini. Okay, syarikat yang kamu mulakan atau kumpulan ini. Satu Facebook account, satu Instagram account, ataupun account yang lain. Sekurang-kurangnya satu. Facebook ke, Instagram ke, WhatsApp ke, TikTok ke, yang boleh kamu post, kamu upload video kamu ataupun gambar tentang produk anda, promosi anda dalam Facebook ataupun Instagram dan sebagainya. Okay, dan pada masa yang sama, okay, setiap kumpulan each group is then responsible for writing their own business e-portfolio report and reporting their sales figure on the Go e-commerce website. This one I will explain it later again. I'll show you how to register later. You try to register. If you can't register, you let me know. Each student should follow the SOP by the local government. Okay, this is understood. So the first method is the very traditional method, is you prepare the product and then you sell it. Okay, but you sell by sending it. Buat penghantaran, you hantar saja. Okay, hantar produk itu saja ke tempat yang berdekatan. Okay, I will not recommend that you must use a post to sell, because some things like food and beverage, you might not be able to use post to sell. But however, kalaulah produk kamu sesuai dihantar melalui post, boleh dihantar ke tempat lain, another city, that then I encourage you to try that. Kalau ada kamu dapat, kamu jual kelompok khasnya yang resipi dia sedap contohnya, dan orang dari Semenanjung ingin membeli produk kamu, then barangan kamu memang boleh dihantar melalui post. Kalau begitu boleh, you can sell it by post. Otherwise, you look for local business. Alright. The second thing, look at the what you call gig economy. Gig economy. So gig economy is any kind of services, any kind of services where each group member may focus on offering their paid short-term services. Maksudnya kamu bekerja sebagai freelancer online atau within certain area, offline pun boleh. So apa yang contoh yang anda boleh buat ialah create advertisement for a local company or a small business. Contohnya kita lihat banyak small syarikat kecil sekarang mereka cuba menjual melalui Facebook. Tapi apa yang mereka menjual ditunjukkan dalam Facebook mereka ialah gambar produk. Ada gambar produk yang sangat cantik, ada gambar produk yang kurang jelas dan sebagainya. Jadi, anda sebagai satu kumpulan, anda yang, kalau adalah untuk mereka yang ada skill, kemahiran dan sebagainya, anda boleh menggunakan ini sebagai satu peluang perniagaan. So, you ask them, you want me to help you to design an advertisement or not? I help you to design advertisement, you pay me a certain small amount. Okay, charge lah berapa ringgit ke berapa untuk satu advertisement. Okay, so if they are happy with your advertisement, then this will be your long-term business. Okay, memang saya ada satu kumpulan semester lalu, mereka disebabkan MCO telah menukar produk yang mereka jual makanan kepada satu perkhidmatan online, okay? Online business. Apa yang mereka buat ialah mereka menyediakan perkhidmatan, dan perkhidmatan ini mendapat satu respon yang sangat baik. Okay, nah charge mereka sangat murah saja, RM5, RM10 begitu. And then they get a very good response, and then their business continue to grow even until today. Okay, jadi ini boleh kamu buat. Contohnya create advertisement, ataupun contohnya kamu membantu mereka menyediakan satu video, video menerangkan produk. Okay, dan biasanya mereka ambil gambar saja. Mereka tidak tahu bagaimana membuat advertisement, tidak tahu bagaimana membuat video. So you have them to prepare advertisement, prepare video, and then you ask them to pay for that. Ask them to pay buyer, and then if they're willing to do it, they ask you to pay. They pay for you, then you get the business. Alright. So this is one method. So for other rules, for example, you have to do posting, responsible, and SOP. All these are the same. Huh? Okay. For SURAM, SURAM is digitalize any local businesses nearby. Jadi apa yang anda buat ialah sebagai seorang penasihat ataupun pembantu membolehkan bisnes tempatan memulakan perniagaan mereka dalam online. Okay, contohnya ada kedai kopi menjual makanan. Makanan mereka memang famous, tapi untuk orang tempatan saja. Mungkin kamu boleh membantu mereka buatlah satu platform, digital platform dalam Facebook ke dalam Instagram, dan ini memang saya galakkan kamu juga minta bayaran, tapi untuk kos yang rendah lah. Jangan kamu minta bayaran 1000 ke 2000, memang mereka tidak mau, because you are very new. But you as a student, you have many skills such as you know how to record videos, you know how to improve editing, all this, then you can help them to start to prepare a beautiful blog, a website or Facebook for them to post their product, and then you can also train their workers to do that. There are some local businessmen, they don't know how to do it. They want to learn, but they don't know who can train them. So this is one method, digitalize, membantu mereka memulakan perniagaan dalam digital platform, digital marketing. Next, we will look at it. Another one is the e-commerce. E-commerce lebih kurang sama. Each member has to focus on any kind of products on e-commerce. For example, using Lazada, Shopee. But I will say Lazada a bit hard. Shopee will be easier. Boleh lah, try. Kalau kamu ada produk yang kamu rasa boleh jual melalui Shopee, boleh try juga. Each group member may focus on offering their paid short-term services, again, same thing as short-term services, online or within their own location. For example, membantu menjual dalam Shopee dan sebagainya. Sebenarnya e-commerce ini lebih kurang sama dengan SURAM. Okay, lebih kurang sama. Cuma ini e-commerce ini kamu boleh membuat perniagaan sendiri online. Okay, online e-commerce platform sendiri melalui Shopee ialah satu memang lebih tinggi lah. Kalau tidak, kamu start dengan Facebook atau WhatsApp saja, mungkin lebih mudah. And then last will be virtual event management. Of course, now you can see during MCO, banyak event dilaksanakan dalam online platform seperti Facebook Live, YouTube dan sebagainya. Dan ini boleh kamu jadikan satu peluang, because you can organize event, okay? Organize event, dan organize event ini melalui Facebook Live contohnya. Kamu sebagai organizer, kamu mendapat bayaran organizing sahaja. Contohnya, you start a group training about, for example, training about video editing. Kalaulah kamu rasanya ataupun kamu tahu ramai orang ingin belajar tentang video editing, then you find a speaker for it, for the training. Carilah seorang speaker yang boleh dipercayai ya. Then you ask the speaker how much he is willing to pay, how much he need to pay to provide a 1 hour training, for example. Contohlah, dia minta bayaran 1 jam RM200. Katakanlah dia very good and then very famous, dia minta bayaran RM200. Then you get how many people? You get at least 20 people. So each one of them have to pay maybe RM12. Jadi kalau kamu dapat 20 orang menghadiri satu program, then you get the profit already. Then you get a good profit. So this is one way to do event management. Of course, it's a bit hard. Okay, it's a bit hard for you to start because you don't have experience to do event. But you can think about it. Lihatlah. Contohnya saya nampak dalam Facebook, ada yang blogger yang celebrities online yang sangat famous kerana menunjukkan cara masakan, food preparation dan sebagainya. Dan mereka menjadi mendapat banyak orang lah ingin advertise produk mereka dan sebagainya. Okay, di melalui blogger tu cara dia. Okay, so this is some of the ways of doing business that you can consider with your group. Okay, ada soalan yang nak tanya tentang group assignment ni? Ada soalan? Okay, you can type your soalan if you have questions about the group assignment. Okay, I think I see a question for Shi Prasad. Madam, for the individual assignment, we should do either a review or an advertisement? Yes. For the individual assignment, you choose one product. And then for that product, you either do a review or an advertisement, or the or is very important. So when you do review, you don't need to do advertisement. If you do advertisement, you don't need to do review. Or you combine both together in one video, it's okay. Okay, that means you do review and at the same time you do advertisement in the same video, okay. So that is how you do the individual assignment. I think I have another question, Shireen. Shireen and Madam, I have my own business that is currently running. I'm selling tote bags with my own design that I draw. Okay, can I just use that instead or do I have to create a new one? Okay, maybe Shireen, you have your good own business, very good. Okay, I will say congrats. You at least you try out something, and maybe you can consider. Okay, if now I have the product, what else can I do? Before this, what are you doing? Maybe you can do, maybe before that you do a simple selling only. Now with your group members together, what extra thing you can do? For example, before this you do a simple promotion using Facebook. Now what else you can do? Maybe you can start to expand your business. Before this, you do it locally. Now you expand your business, you start to do it like e-commerce, you sell online using Shopee. Right? Try to think beyond the box. You're not only doing the same thing, but you can start to think and then start to expand. Okay, all right. I think you say I already have it in Shopee. Then what else you can do? Okay, start to think about it. Maybe you are doing back. What else can you do with your design besides bag? What else can you do? Maybe if you are doing different thing, all right? I think you are very creative, so I think you can do much better. Then maybe I'm really expect to see how your what you are going to do in your group project later. And then I hope people are sharing, you have the experience, you can guide your friends together, and then you improve yourself together. Okay, I look at another student, No Shabina. Madam, for the selling product, do we have certain KPI? No, you don't have KPI, I keep performing tax. That is for people working for companies. Okay, you don't have KPI, you only have one objective. First, you learn how to do business from this practicum project. Okay, you have one very important thing you learn. Second, you learn how to communicate better with your friends, with your group members. This is also very important. Third, you know, you try to use your creativity, your entrepreneurship skills further, improve yourself from this project. This is what we expect from you, okay? So, and then at the same time, please, you have to report your sales in the e-commerce, but we will not see, oh, how much you sell, I give you better marks. No, your marks is not based on how much you sell, how much money you earn, but your sales is based on what you learned. Okay, your marks based on what you learn. If we feel that you learn a lot of things, then bear in mind you get your marks. Okay, so if you ask your seniors of last semester when they are doing business online, all of a sudden they have to change a business because last semester all of a sudden we have to go from face to face to class. They have to change a business last minute, but still they still do very good. Okay, you can get some experience, you can ask your senior about it. All right, so this is some of it. All right, so if you have questions, you can still ask later from the chat. Okay, so overview of the individual assignment guideline, like I say, you have quiz and you have content creation. All right, so you can please read the description here. Okay, description here, and then for example, they say a video must be original, meaning that don't copy the video from other people to put into your video. For example, I watched one video. Out of the 2 minutes, at least 1 minute he copied from the website of that product, and then he put it into his video. So I will give you half of the marks. All right. And then next, for example, informal language, you can use any language, but yang penting saya boleh faham. Okay, if you speak Tamil, saya tidak faham, saya tidak boleh pakai mata. So you understand this, ah? And then, okay, at the same time also, for video kan, ini video creation untuk orang ramai, bukan untuk saya. So you can use any method to promote your product. Okay, some very interesting thing is, I see semester lalu, contohnya, dia tunjukkan bagaimana membuat pencucian muka, kan tekan, dia tunjukkan step one, bagaimana anda buat. This is very interesting, dan kalau lah dia post dalam YouTube kepada orang ramai pun suka nak baca, watch the video dan sebagainya. So, this video must be list, must be upload into YouTube or TikTok account. Okay, semester lalu kita guna YouTube saja, tetapi untuk semester ini kita guna TikTok account. Eh? Jadi untuk TikTok account ni, anda mesti buka dia, make it public, okay, make it public, and please do not delete it. Okay, janganlah make it private after submission. Sebab semasa saya, kamu mungkin submit dalam Disember, tapi mungkin saya tak sempat watch. I haven't watched your video yet. You already change it to private, so I cannot give you marks. It's a bit difficult, okay? I think I have one comment here, one question here. Is a review same as critics or can be positive or negative, right, doctor? Yes, you can have positive and negative also at the same time for a product. For example, you review a product, for example, you review a handphone, then you start to say the good, all the good things, but also you say, oh, one limitation is of this handphone is the, maybe the camera is not as good, okay, tapi I think still is very good for us already, for this price, this, even though the camera is not very good, but still, this is the best camera you can find for, or very good camera that you can find for this price, for example. Okay, you can critics. You can have negative comments, but at the same time, you have to tell me, make it possible for people to understand you. When you say negative things, at the same time, why you still want to buy this product? Okay, take it, make it in mind. Kalau kamu buat review, your purpose is to introduce a product. So when you review the product, you can say something negative a bit, but you can explain why you think this is the negative point. Okay. Next, no, Sabrina, another question. Any product, right, doctor, including food? You mean video creation? Yes. You can you can do a video creation for any product, but jangan buatlah contohnya nasi lemak. Okay. The product is so common already. Kenapa mau buat review untuk nasi lemak? Faham tak? You can review a product for the purpose you either to do advertisement. Katakanlah, kamu ada satu produk yang makanan lah. Oh, nasi lemak khas Pakcik Long, katakan. Okay, this is the special brand, nasi lemak khas Pakcik Long. Apa kelebihannya? Sambal dia berbeza, contohnya makanan berbeza. Okay, then it is okay. Because when you do review, you review the product with a brand. Bukanlah nasi lemak saja. Yang mana-mana pun kamu pun boleh dapat nasi lemak. Janganlah review nasi lemak yang begitu biasa sudah kita faham, kita tahu. Okay. Alright, so remember, you do a review because you want to either introduce people or you do a soft selling, hard selling, so that people will interested to know more or will want to buy it. Okay, alright, so we continue with flat lay photography. Katakanlah flat lay photography ini ialah mengambil gambar. I told you just now. Ambil gambar, simpan gambar di atas meja ke with beautiful decoration, anything, then ambil gambar dari atas. Okay, what we call flat lay is 90 degree. Okay, ataupun mesti dari sebelah yang 90 degree, ataupun dari atas 90 degree. It's better to take photo from 90 degree top perspective, is easier. Okay, take using the four tips, then mesti original. Okay, please original. So for video and photo, video and photo guna produk yang sama. Video dan foto guna produk yang sama. Dan foto ini tolong post dalam Instagram for education purposes. Okay, kedua-dua ini saya expect original. Maksudnya kamu buat sendiri, bukan copy ya, bukan copy atau bound kamu ambil gambar dari tempat lain masukkan, bukan. And then untuk foto ini, kamu masuk dalam Instagram account. Yang kamu buka account itu khas untuk public. Jadi biasanya saya minta Instagram account ini dibuka you open a new account. You get a new account, Instagram account for this course. Okay? You have your account already, but your account normally we don't open it for public. So for this Instagram account, I need you to prepare a new one, okay? Prepare a new one, and then you open it for public. Then you can use this, right? Don't use your personal account, because personal account after that you want to close it, make it private. Tapi sebelum saya sempat tengok gambar kamu, kamu sudah tutup. Itu masalah saya semester lalu juga. Tiap-tiap semester saya bagi tahu soal yang sama, nasihat yang sama, tapi mereka buat lagi. So please take note. And then next, this is the rubrics. You can have a look later. For business model group assignment, business model canvas, BMC report, jumlahnya 30%. 15% for presentation, 15% for written report. Content dia sama sahaja. You can read lah. What type of products, what industry, what kind of product service you want to sell. How did you identify the business idea? Who is in your company? Maksudnya siapakah pengurus, siapakah ketua dan sebagainya. 9 business areas. Later I will explain the 9 business area. What are the risks, conclusion, contingency plan, reference and empathics. Okay? So okay, this is for BMC. You do the same thing. You prepare a draft. By week 4, you present it. After that, I give you comment and you use the comment and the draft to prepare your report. The same thing. Okay? Dan laporan ini sama slide ini dihantar melalui Google Form. Okay? Melalui form. I will show you the Google Classroom later. Okay. So seterusnya, business e-portfolio report 50%. 50% di mana 20% for presentation and 30% for the written report. Jadi ada dua bahagian. Section 1, the first section is the portfolio. In simple, explain what the business are doing, business is doing, what kind of business practical, what industry you do, what products, service, who is in your company. Same thing. siapakah pengurus dan sebagainya, your organization job chart and so on. How did you promote? Okay, for example, your poster, your Facebook, your Instagram, your store, if you have the face-to-face store, or if you do selling, you use runner, all these you keep a record. What was your business or company achievement? Contohnya sales, jualan. Followers, kalau kamu ada Facebook, kalau semakin ramai followers atau likes, maksudnya semakin popular lah produk kamu. So that's one way, sales and profit of your company or other local business. Okay, next, section 2. This is to prepare by everybody together. Remember, we have to see what each member is doing. Bukan satu orang kerja, semua orang perlu buat bersama. So everybody should do the same thing. That is first, what kind of product or problems you are facing? What are your solutions? What do you think? So especially for this part, I expect most everybody contribute your perception. For example, a person explain from his perspective, another team member will explain from another perspective, and you combine together as the reflection. So reflection 3 pages, maybe you can extend to 5 pages. Okay, so let's say you have about 5 classmates, 5 group members or 7 group members, then satu orang lebih kurang satu paragraph lah, panjang. Jadi lebih kurang 7 orang, mungkin 4 muka surat or 5 pages. Okay, and remember for both business portfolio report and presentation and report written, you mesti sediakan appendix, contohnya screenshot your social media platform, social media insight, contohnya your WhatsApp, your poster, your Facebook, semua ini perlu tunjukkan dalam appendix. So we expect a very long appendix. Wrong appendix. If you have your WhatsApp, your website for this, also you can include here. Okay, you can include here. Any more questions for the group? Any more questions for the group assignment? All right, I have about 90 students today, but I think some of you might not able to register this group. I'm very sorry because bagian BPA yang membuatkan kamu register pada 15. Saya pun heran kenapa dia mau kamu register pada 15 sahaja, tetapi kami disuruh. Okay, we were told that you must be master our class early. So I invite everybody to come in. Whoever wanted to join my class to come in here. Cuma kalau yang tidak dapat, tidak apa. At least you know what you want to do or you need to do for this APK course, alright? When will we know which group we will be assigned to? Okay, soalan yang baik oleh Eko. So, I also want to know when will you know. Because saya perlukan nama ataupun senarai nama anda dulu sebelum saya boleh tentukan kumpulan, first thing. Second thing I need to know is I need to you to answer a survey, satu kajian pelajar tentang your internet connectivity. Okay, saya perlukan anda first register dulu. So, yang kedua survey, saya perlu lihat survey kamu. Okay, lalu saya boleh tentukan kumpulan anda. Because it's not like last semester. Semester lalu kita semua dalam kampus. Jadi saya pagilah ikut kumpulan masing-masing. Ha? Tak perlu risau kamu satu orang di Tawau, satu orang di KL, bagaimana berurusan. This is might be a big issue. So for this semester, I wait for 2 things. First, the complete name list. Okay. Second thing, I wait for your answer to the survey. After I have these 2 completed, then only I can give you the group. And I hope after next week, I will get the list. At least the latest is by 1 week after, maybe 20 hari bulan. Saya haraplah boleh dapat selepas 20 hari bulan Oktober. Okay. So I need your help that. Okay, two things. Sebelum saya boleh tentukan your kumpulan. Okay. Group will be around 6 to 7 persons in a group. Yeah, around 6 to 7 persons. Nah, saya cuba masukkan kamu ikut tempat, but I cannot promise that. Okay, I cannot promise. Nah, saya tidak boleh kata mestilah. Kalau ada 2 orang saja dari Santakan dalam kumpulan ini pun tidak boleh buat kerja. Jadi, I have to get people nearby Santakan, maybe Lahat Datu to work together. That's what I can do. Alright. So this is the rubric. Please have a role forming the group requirements. Okay. Oh, sorry. This is important thing. Formal requirements. In total to pass, you must achieve composite marks of at least 35%. Jumlah markah mesti melebihi 35 markah first. Submit all assignment and attend 100% of the task. This is very important. Okay, kalau tidak kamu dapat extra. So for the lecture details, I think you don't need to look at everybody. So this is in simple. For this week, we will look at briefing. Next week only, I will start unit 1. So week 2, I will start unit 1, 2, 3. If I can complete all the 3 units, I hope. And week 3, I will explain BA Business Model Canvas, BMC, the presentation report. Okay, this grouping, I will do it. For this week 3, I hope that after the lecture, you will start to do. Actually, I plan if I can have all of your name list, everything by week 2, then you can start to do your, I will let you know your grouping by week 2. But I'm not very sure whether I can do it or not. Okay, so we go to at least by week 4, you have your grouping ready, and then week 3, you have your grouping ready, and then by week 4 will be your presentations. Okay, week 4 will be your presentation. It's okay if you don't present very well because you might not have enough time to prepare, but at least this presentation, BMC report, is to prepare for your written report. That is very important. I will give you comments to improve your BMC report, so it will be nice after that. Week 5, marketing. Unit 5, I will explain marketing. Week 6, I will explain digital marketing for business. Same thing, week 7 will be digital marketing. Week 8 will be unit 7, financial and accounting. And unit 8, risk management before the semester break. Alright, so I will recommend if you can do it, at least you're selling somewhere around week 8, week 9, it will be fine. Or even during the semester break to do your business, it will be fine. Okay, and then week 9 will be unit 9 management. Week 10 will be your business legal forms and support system. It means that by week 10, you have to complete your practicum activities. Okay, week 10. You finish your business and then you can continue to do your business. But formally, our record for business that you have to report to me is until week 10. But you are encouraged to continue your business. So as we memang boleh saya continue lah, memang boleh. Okay, I have students to ask me, boleh saya continue lah business ya? Boleh, memang boleh. You don't need to ask me. For my requirement, I require you to report what you did from week 5 until week 10 only. Okay, because I cannot tell you to continue until week 14, then only I give you marks. No. Okay, I expect you at least to do until week 10. So by week 10, you have your business, you know how much money you make, then you do a report. Week 11, they will arrange an industrial talk by some maybe outside the local businessmen and so on. We will look at it. And then you remember, you have to report individual sales on the e-commerce website. And then entrepreneurial ethics on week 12. Normally, I will start to present presentation week 12. So I will try to complete this unit 11 in week 10 also. I will make it earlier. Unit 10 and 11, I'll complete it earlier. So that week 12 and 13, I will let you to do the presentation. 2 hours presentation is not enough for all the groups. So I'll try to make it in 2 weeks. Week 12 and week 13, and week 14 will be the report. Very likely we don't have class. If we our presentation not complete, then we will have class in week 14. Okay, I think I have one question by Arin Haran. Okay, the course outline is in Google Classroom. Yes, you can download the course outline in the Google Classroom. So the course resources, you can download it from Smart V3. I don't use Schoology, but I use Google Platform, and then Go E-commerce. So you can have a look at this outline in more details, and please download it from the Google website. Google Classroom. Sorry. Okay. I'll stop sharing this. Next, I will want to stop presenting that. Okay. Next, I will want to present another the Google Classroom. Okay, before I continue with Google Classroom, may I know, may I please answer in chat, may I know, did you or have you ever used Google Classroom before for your online class before this? Yes or no? Yes, yes. Wow, yes. Okay, so good. I will explain a little bit. I see a few notes. Okay, I will explain a little bit about the Google Classroom. Okay, all right, some no, some yes. Never mind, I'll explain to you for people who never use Google Classroom before. All right, I'll explain it a little bit. If you still don't understand how to use Google Classroom, please ask the question in WhatsApp after the class. Okay, after the class. Okay. Second thing, can you see the classroom that I show you? Present now. Can you see the classroom I present now to you? Can I? Okay, good. All right. Of course, I am as the lecturer, so I will show you my lecturer method. This for you is similar. Okay, for you is similar. You can see the classwork, stream, classwork, and people. So if you only have you click the classroom code that I gave you earlier, the classroom code, then you will join my classroom. Okay, let me see how many people in my class already. Yeah, I have 83 of you. Okay, but I believe not all of you able to register. So after that, I might need to delete those people who are not in my group. Okay, so this is for your information. So this is my page as the teacher for this group. Okay, stream. When you look at the stream, then I will have some first posting for you. So this is the first posting. I post the same thing in your WhatsApp group. Okay, I post the same thing in your WhatsApp group. So if you don't have the, you haven't joined this classroom yet, I think I have 90 over students just now log into my Google Meet. For those who haven't joined the class yet, please check the WhatsApp group for the class code. You just create, you will get it, right? So I will have the posting here. Of course, all the assignments I already post in advance. Okay, second thing, this is the most important thing. Can you see that? Your first task is to fill in a survey on student internet connection. Yes, okay, you can find the link in the classwork. So, okay, where is the classwork? Go to upstairs. Okay, see this classwork? Under classwork, right? Under classwork, you can see something like this. Okay, okay. The first thing you can see is the attendance. So what you have to do is click the attendance after the class today, and then click this to fill in your attendance. Okay. So 84 of you already assigned, meaning that I have 84 students now in this group, okay, who already joined the classroom group, already joined the classroom 84, but nobody answer me, never mind. After this, you can click every day, every time after the lecture, please click this to answer your attendance. Just click it, then you can answer the attendance. If you have problems, you let me know. Okay, so the first thing, attendance. So go to classwork again, go to classwork, click the attendance for your attendance every day after the class. So, and at the same time, I will counter check your attendance with your sign in time, because when you sign in the Google Meet, okay, and kami guna Google Meet, dan Google Meet akan automatic record time kamu masuk class, okay, time kamu masuk class, time kamu log out. So I will check attendance ini dengan time dalam Google Time Meet kamu. Sekurang-kurangnya kamu ada join class saya sekurang-kurangnya 5 minit, 10 minit, saya assume you attend. Okay, so that's why I say, if possible, you use the same address, email address for attendance and Google Meet. Jadi saya tahu lah siapa of mereka. Okay, kalau different address for attendance, different address for Google Meet, it will be a bit difficult for me. Ini perkara pertama. You have to do it every week. Okay, selepas the class, after the class. Second thing, fill in this. This will be the first assignment you have to do. Okay, ada soalan tak? Fill in this survey. Survey, sama juga. Okay, ada 3 orang sudah cuba try. Okay, please I request the 3 of you to redo it again. Kalau sudah buat, kamu buat sebelum ini, sebelum hari ini. Kamu buat kemarin tu, saya minta kamu buat balik. So, I change a little bit of questions sebab ada kesilapan pula. Ada kesilapan. Jadi, saya minta tolong kamu yang sudah isi tu, tolong isi balik. Same thing. Okay, dalam classwork, tekan classwork, tekan ini, kamu boleh nampak survey. Okay, tekan ini saja. Tekan survey, then you get the Google form. So, I make it using one platform, satu platform untuk semua material yang ada. Contohnya, course outline yang telah saya pentangkan tadi, I present just now, you can see that it's here, you can download it now. Sebelum tu saya guna drive, salah lah, saya upload it using a long way. Jadi saya masuk balik using, I improve it using upload PDF. Now it is much better, okay? You can download it without password needed. Same thing, assignment for week. This is the assignment that you need to do, and then I arrange it by week, so it will be easier for you to see what you have to do by every week, okay? You can keep this somewhere near your desktop, wherever you want to check when to submit. This is the due date inside it, okay? Assignment by week, for example. Boleh nampak tu? Okay, for example, I have the classroom link here for you. Okay, week 4, presentation. Week 5 to 10, practicum project. Week 6, quiz 1. Week 7, written PMC report. Week 8, content creation. Untuk video dan flat lay foto. Okay, week 11, sales reporting. Maksudnya selepas ini, you buat reporting lah. To go e-commerce website. So who should do it or what to do by individual or by group. And then week 12 to 13, business e-portfolio report, presentation in class. And then week 14, again, report, written report, prepare and upload in blog or website and provide link via Google Forms. This is what you have to do, and group leader have to in charge of this, okay? You can download this after this. Next, individual assignment. So this is for you to submit your individual assignment once you prepare. Okay. For example, you click here. Then there are some a little bit of outlines for you, and then you can click view assignment. For example, then oh sorry. Because I'm the lecturer, so when I click is view assignment. For you, when you click, then for you as a student, when you click, then it will be a link that you can provide your photo and video clips in that Google form. It will be a link in Google form. But for this one, because I'm using I'm a teacher view, so I only can view assignment. Okay, sorry. Okay, next. This is the link. This is the link. You just click the link. Okay, I think someone, Noah Shrapina, asked me, do we need to click the turn in button in the Google Classroom for the attendance? Okay, okay. For this, all right, I will recommend you to click this turn in button. Okay, you click the attendance. Click the attendance, you will see something like this, lecture. All right, I think somebody already. No, this turning mean maksudnya kamu turn in kan, but I will need more details, so you better click the Google form. Boleh tekan turn in, but yang penting click the Google form dan isi di dalam Google form. Okay, you can click this and isi Google form. Okay, you can I think better to turn in lah, maybe. Alright, turn in, click ini dan isi Google form kalau ada lah button. Okay. Wait. For individual assignment, next is sales reporting. Sales reporting ini untuk kamu report dalam Go e-commerce website. Jadi saya akan link you to the Go e-commerce website. Alright, and in this Go e-commerce website, you have to register it. Okay, register the Go e-commerce website. I think I don't have enough time to explain. I will explain the Go e-commerce website next week. Okay, saya akan terangkan bagaimana kamu register Go e-commerce website minggu depan. But you have to do the reporting. Due date is on the 1st of January 2021. Next, okay. Group assignment, BMC presentations, okay, BMC report, BMC e-portfolio presentation, BMC e-portfolio group report. Ini untuk ketua kumpulan atau wakil kumpulan lah. Saya perlukan satu orang menjawab saja. So one person prepare the slide and upload to this using Google Form. Okay, one student saja. Tak perlu kalau tujuh orang hantar tak perlu. I need one. Biasanya group leader lah. Kalau group leader tak boleh buat, okay, minta kamu minta lah. Ahli kumpulan yang boleh buat. So, fill in this form to submit. Inside the form, there is a link actually. Let me see if I can click the link. Okay. Yeah, you have the, I think, oh, I cannot show you the link, huh? Never mind. Okay, the link is there. Then you just fill in. Same thing with PMC report. Dan untuk laporan PMC, tolong hantar dalam PDF. Okay, I will explain here a little bit. You see PDF, then you change it to PDF. Okay, presentation, you can put it in the presentation or PDF. Okay, for e-portfolio, ialah dalam website. Okay, link dalam website. So this is for the classroom. Okay, for the classroom. So in if you have question about the classroom, please ask now. Cuba tanya kalau ada soalan untuk Google Classroom dalam chat. Ada? Ada Google Classroom? Ada mau tanya soalan? Kalau tiada, then I'll stop this presentation on Google Classroom. Hasilnya mereka yang baru, you never use Google Classroom. So this Google Classroom, you can see they are people. Of course, you don't see these people, because I am as a lecturer, I can see how many people in my group. Tapi apa yang anda lihat ialah stream, classwork, and grades untuk individual saja. Okay, I'm trying to upload some of the materials here later, because I still don't have most of the materials with me. So, apa yang saya ada, saya upload sahaja yang ada lah. Yang di atas tu, okay, saya akan upload nanti. Okay, so for your information, kalau di atas soalan, saya nampak macam di atas soalan. So, okay, stop presenting at the moment. Kalau tiada soalan, okay, saya minta lah, saya minta kamu buat dua, remember two things. First, fill in the attendance for today. Remember, guna Google Classroom. Second, ialah, oh saya lupa suruh kan, student internet connection survey. Itu mesti buat. Let me post balik lah, present balik. Present now. Yeah. Classroom. Okay, jangan lupa for student internet connection survey mesti jawab juga. Because for this survey is to ask you how good is your internet connection. Saya minta address dan bandar, city that or pekan yang paling dekat dengan kampung kamu ke dengan rumah kamu. Okay, I request that. Untuk membuat kerja kumpulan. Jadi saya minta semua jawab student internet connection survey ini. Okay. Selepas kamu jawab attendance, jangan lupa jawab ini. Ini sekali saja. Okay. So please take note lah untuk mereka yang baru masuk ke atau tidak jelas tadi, tolong try lah. You try. If you have problem with this Google Classroom, you can ask me personally after the class. Okay. For this, you must do. Alright, so I will stop the presenting for this one. Okay, one last call. Any questions from you? One last call? Ada soalan? Okay, I think people say okay already. Thank you. Nadia? About the group assignment, can we create by on self? Sorry. Tak boleh. Okay, I will try to make it you are in the same city or Pekan. Okay, so what is the code for the Google Classroom? The code for the Google Classroom, please go to the WhatsApp group to check for the Google Classroom. Okay, I will post it again for those who don't have the Google Classroom yet, haven't joined yet. Okay, I will propose it. All right, any more questions? Google Classroom, what else? Okay. All right, okay, before I end the class, anyone willing to open your camera? Anyone want to open your camera now? You on your camera, then we take a group photo. Okay, next week onwards, I will ask this question also. Whoever want to show your face, it's okay now, okay? If you are not ready, it's fine. But I will ask you so that, tengok lah, huh? I'll show you, oh, shy, never mind, it's okay. I know some of you not prepared. Okay, wow, handsome boy, eh? Nampak sudah. Okay, good. All right. So thank you for attending the class because I want to screenshot this to keep a record of the students who can attend my class. It's fine. I know some of you maybe not prepared. Belum sedia tutungga dan sebagainya. It's fine. Okay, I just keep record whoever here. Take some photo here. Let's screenshot. All right. Thank you very much for attending the class, and thank you very much for sharing your face, together. All right. If you have any question, please do ask me during the in the WhatsApp group. All right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Have a nice week. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Any questions? Same thing. Ask me using WhatsApp group, please. Huh? Have a nice week. Okay. All right. I've still stopped the video. Thank you.